Over the years, I created more than 100 videos. Last year alone, it was 52 for this channel, every week one video. And the vast majority of my videos are talking heads, meaning one talking head, the rest is static. And some of them I've taken the camera into the wild. Now, the beautiful thing about the studio setup is once you have set up your home office, you can really go for efficiency from a production standpoint, setting everything up, filming, and then going to post. While taking it out into the wild, in my experience, but maybe I'm not as talented, it takes a lot more effort specifically in post-production. But looking at data, it's obvious that the videos where the camera came with me into the wild have more views than others. And so I figured it's time to shake things up. And at the same time, I saw this video from Casey Neistat on his YouTube channel where he announced that he's gonna publish a class on monthly.com where he takes participants through his process from the beginning to the final product. And so while I've never been a huge fan of his, I did like his style because he had a bit of a rough style and it didn't seem he's obsessing so much over equipment than some of the other channels I followed. So I signed up. And so in this episode, I'm going to share with you some of the learnings so that you can decide for yourself if you should sign up for it as well or if you're going to give a pass on it. Casey really did not obsess about the equipment at all. First video we've done in this class was on our smartphone. No equipment. It just was so refreshing to put the story at the center and not obsessing over which lens, which camera or whatnot, but really just go find an interesting topic and make a video about it. What was particularly interesting and insightful for me is like how Casey makes the transition in post-production. So basically, if he cuts in the middle of a sentence or a scene like me sitting out here, he will make a cut, but then take the audio file from what comes after the cut and use it as second audio line that fades out. And so the cut doesn't seem as harsh because you have the background noise, etc., ongoing into this next clip. So that's was like, wow, that's so cool. Now he made it look very easy with the editing software he's using, and I think he's using the Final Cut from Mac, while I struggled a little bit on DaVinci, but that also has definitely to do because I just switched from Premiere to DaVinci. The second video in the class was supposed to be a topic we always had on our mind or we wanted to make a video. And there he challenged us kind of like to put our best foot forward using better equipment. Now again, it wasn't about what you're using as much as just put the most effort in it, try to apply anything he has learned. He obviously has a very prime camera with a prime lens, but he, for example, doesn't use lights. He films always during the daytime, so he doesn't have to worry about lighting. I feel I learned a lot, but you can be the judge. You can watch any, let's say, videos from before the 100 and the one I link up here, which will be the one I made about bicycle buying, which was basically my second video for the project. So for who is this class? This class, I think, is for anybody that wants to get started without investing too much money into camera and equipment, because it really focuses on the storytelling part. He shows one-to-one how much he's obsessing in post-production to really make sure he has an interesting story that stays engaging through the whole time. And so you learn that in this class. If you're already a professional, for sure, you can always learn something, but I think it's less targeting to you. Some of the first participants in his class created a Facebook group, and I saw some critique there. And some of the critique obviously is true. I think there is potential even for Casey and the monthly.com crew to improve that. I think many looked forward to get some feedback from Casey himself, which I would say would be nice, but obviously that doesn't scale much depending on how many participants they have. So I understand if that is not. The other thing that I was missing was audio. Somehow his audio is not perfect, but pretty good and consistent, which was a surprise because he puts the camera in a bunch of different directions. But when he talks, it's almost like he always had exactly the same distance to the microphone. And so I'm not sure if he used the lavalier during these videos that he produced, but we spent basically zero time on it. So it's not the perfect class that teaches you everything, but I will link some videos if you want to look into audio processing and classes you can take there. But again, if you just want to get started, I think this is the class to take.